श्रुति, मुक्ता या मुक्ता, शिवानी, यशस्विनी, संध्या जी, प्लीज कम. काजल, इज एस्ट्रोलॉजिकल, शी वांट्स टू नो. कम सिट. संध्या जी आइए. संध्या जी, I'd also like to invite on stage the writer and director of the film, Priyanka Banerjee. And my partner in crime and co-founder of Electric Apples Entertainment, Ryan Stephen, who was responsible for this cast. It was his idea to cast these beautiful women in the film. So yeah, so now before throwing the house open to questions to all the people who are involved with the film, what I'd like to do is just ask the entire people connected to the film to speak a little bit about what Devi means to them. Starting with you, Kajal.
Okay, I really wasn't prepared for this one. I thought I'd be answering questions on what Devi actually meant to y'all more than us. For me, the film was a very simple matter to do. I mean, I think that lots of people always ask me that, you know, oh, aapne ye picture kyun ki? You know, isme kya achha tha? Aur mera jawab hamesha raha hai ki, you know, mujhe script bahut achhi lagi hai. Ya mujhe, you know, I liked this, iska jo kirdar tha, mujhe bahut interesting laga ya jo bhi hai. Lekin Devi ke script ke baare mein jab main kahungi, to main kahungi, haan, script achhi thi. Lekin I think iska jo message hai aur ye jo kehna chahta hai, ye picture jo kehna chahta hai, I think that is more important than anything else. I think sabse zyada, aur main ye sawal bhi aapke liye answer kar deti hu ki 9 auratein thi aur kisi ne kisi ke sath jhagda kiya over hair and makeup, and I want to tell you no. There were no fights at all, and you know, I think that's what Devi is about, is that we all need to somewhere down the line stand up and support each other and not try to pull each other down or, you know, not give the other person a hand up when they need it.
Shruti.
Good afternoon, everyone. So, as Kajal ma'am said, I don't think it was like a big decision of like, should I be doing this? It was quite obvious that I wanted to be a part of something so powerful and poignant. It's something that as a woman, I don't even think you have to be a woman alone. It's just something that is so reflective of society's numbness to certain issues. And I think that has really come across. And like she said, there's this perception that women don't stand up for each other, and most often not. I think the sisterhood isn't as strong as it should be. And this film kind of goes through that journey, which is what I really, really liked. So thank you, Priyanka, for such a lovely idea, subject, concept, and having us in it. Electric Apples, my two favorites, Ryan and Niranjan. I also have to say, of all the movies I've done, I was the most pampered on this. We had a special lounge with the best food and snacks, which was amazing. And we all got to know each other because it was a very short filming period. And it's really been an honor for me to get to know these incredible women and be a part of this really powerful story.
Nina.
Hello, everybody. I think Kajal and Shruti have pretty much said what all of us feel and very well put. They put it very well in words. For me, I think, see, there are lots of films and there's a lot of content on this particular subject that has been treated over here. But one point that Kajal made, I think I would also like to make, is that standing up for each other, it's not an isolated person who's having it. This is something which happens to womanhood on a regular basis for years and decades and ages. And I hope I can say that it's not, yeah. And I hope I can say that it will not happen hereafter. So I think that unity, that sisterhood, that womanhood message that is given in this script is what really made me emotional and wanting to be a part. You know, for me, Niranjan and Ryan, Electric Apples, I don't ever say no to them. There's no question. In fact, I'm after them. Please give me something. they are the most wonderful producers and friends one can ever, ever encounter. And Priyanka, I must say, for your age and everything, I mean, I saw her, I said, is this the girl who wrote this script? The script is a little theater piece, actually. It's a piece of theater. So kudos to that.
Mukta.
Hello, everyone. Abhi kuch kehne ke liye bacha nahi hai. Ditto, 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 ditto. लेकिन फिर भी थोड़ा कहूँगी, थोड़ी बात तो कहनी ज़रूरी है, क्योंकि देवी जैसे फिल्में बननी ज़रूरी है, लेकिन जिस प्रकार से वो लोगों तक पहुँच रही है, इसके लिए मैं रायन और निरंजन को पहले थैंक्स कहूँगी, कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट करूँगी, क्योंकि इस टाइप का सब्जेक्ट, ये इश्यूज़ डिस्कस करना ज़रूरी है, लेकिन ज़्यादा लोगों तक पहुँचना भी उतना ही ज़रूरी है, और ये काम बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छे से कर रहे हैं. एंड आई एम रियली हैप्पी आज ये प्रेस देख के, जो वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट जिसको कहते हैं, वो सामने भी दिख रहा है, यहाँ भी दिख रहा है, फिल्म में भी दिख रहा है. तो आई एम रियली हैप्पी एंड कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस प्रियंका. वो जानती थी उसे क्या चाहिए था और उसने कर दिखाया. एंड कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस एवरीबडी एंड थैंक यू फॉर हैविंग मी हियर एंड इन द फिल्म ऑल्सो. थैंक यू.
संध्या जी
नमस्कार. सर्वप्रथम मी ॲपल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इंटरमिनेट यांचं निरंजन आणि यांचं धन्यवाद देते की मला ह्या शॉर्ट फिल्ममध्ये काम करायला संधी मिळाली आणि त्याच्या थ्रू मला काही संधी देऊ म्हणजे मी मेसेज पोहोचवू शकले तर मी माझं भाग्य समजेन. आणि थँक्यू प्रियंका. आणि खरंच म्हणजे तिने देवी हे टायटल दिलेलं आहे, स्त्रीनी कोणाच्याही मदतीची याचना न करता स्वतः देवी बनून, देवीच नाही तर कालीमातेचं रूप घेऊन त्याची प्रत्येकाचे हे केलं पाहिजे. काय म्हणतात, कुठलंही संकट आलं तर ती झेलण्याची ताकद ती देवीमध्ये आहे, ती देवीने घेतली पाहिजे. प्रत्येक स्त्रीमध्ये ती देवीची ताकद आली पाहिजे, कालीमातेची ताकद. धन्यवाद, धन्यवाद पुन्हा सगळ्यांना.
शिवानी.
म्हणजे समज नाही आया. आय थिंक या आफ्टर जब सब लोगों ने बोल दिया, आई डोंट नो, आई हैव लेफ्ट विद एनीथिंग, बट द वन थिंग व्हिच आई वुड लाइक टू से, व्हेन आई वाज अ किड आई वाज नेवर फॉन्ड ऑफ दिस वर्ड देवी, because I used to feel that ye ek word dekhe na hum ek pedestal pe chadha dete hain and then we are bound to behave a certain way all our lives and we can't be ourselves truly. But when I saw the because initially the name was something else of the film, and when I saw the way they have written Devi, it's not, it's really beautiful, because it's not Devi, you know, the name is just, I think just somebody has wiped it off. So yeah, so I really loved it. And for me to be part of the script, it was just the script. I read the script. I did not know anybody. I just read the script and I was really moved. Also because it's not teaching you anything. It's just showing you what it is, how it feels. It's not giving you any sort of gyan ki aap ye karo, aap ye mat karo. This is what it is. Now you see what you feel, which I really loved. And yes, like everybody, I would like to thank these two men because they were so lovely. And to be very honest, for me also, like Shruti just said, they were the most wonderful producer one can ever work with. And Priyanka, thank you so much for getting me on board.
Yashaswini.
Because she spoke about, like, when she was younger, she didn't like the word Devi. This sudden memory came in my head. So when all of us cousins were really young, if my brother, even in like a game, he would like push me or like give me like a nudge or something, my nani would get really upset and say, ki, hey, behen Devi hoti hai, you can't hurt her. And so that was my first exposure to the term Devi. And also growing up, like especially like my age children growing up, we were really not interested in learning about a mythology. And so the term Devi just was a word. And then when you grow up and you live life and then you see what's happening around and then you experience the power of the relationship that women can have with each other, the power that women have amongst themselves, and that's when you really start to like, the word starts holding some weight and it's really heavy. So Devi for me is just immense power that's just waiting to be unleashed. Like she's just waiting to break free, like this world just needs to get a little bit more ready. So, and in terms of this film, I genuinely, right from day one, I feel like I'm this super fortunate fly on the wall who has, I don't know how, landed up in this moment here right now to to be amongst this set of people.
But
I
your fly, the fly at the wall has got very cute pigtails in the film.
So yeah, and I hope a lot of people watch this. I hope the right kind of people watch this. And by the right kind of people, I mean the wrong kind of people. And I hope it just does something to their brains. Maybe like kickstart some wiring in their head and make them realize how dirty and filthy their being and the world can become a better place. And thank you, Priyanka, for reaching out to me. Thank you, Ryan and Niranjan, for thinking of me. And yeah, that's all I can say. Thanks.
Like she said, I think you definitely need to raise your voice. I don't think that you can. I don't think that you need to be so very vehement about it. But we all do need to, like she said, start up the debate. Talk about it. If not, if you don't scream about it, don't yell about it, but talk about it. Make your statement in the most practical and logical manner possible. I think that's really where we're lacking. I feel as feminists, I feel fanaticism is not going to get you anywhere, because all it does is just prove to you know, all the patriarchal society that you're
hysterical.
Yeah, that you're hysterical and that you're PMSing. So I mean, like, you know, just prove them wrong in that sense, and just approach it with a very practical, sensible approach.
Well, I personally feel we ourselves should be the change. I mean, I would bring up my children. I am bringing up and have brought them up the way I feel, because my parents did that. I mean, I've been in this field for 46 years. I began with theater. And the other day I was telling somebody, at that time, it never ever struck me that I was a girl and this guy's a boy. And we used to, literally, and today it is that. I feel sad, you know. As I know, you know, when all these years, it's finally come to this, but at the same time, voices are being raised. It's not that rape didn't exist then, it did exist behind closed doors. Exploitation was there behind, nobody said anything, just live with it and creatively got out, or, you know, committed suicide or whatever. But today, people are voicing it. I think that's a very positive thing. But as Shruti and Kajal both said, don't just voice it. You have to, it has to be inherent in you. We can only be the change, and we must put our foot down. I don't think I'm lesser than anybody else. I mean, just because a guy comes and roars at me, I'll roar double at him. But we don't have to be a man to prove that we are a woman.
Exactly.
We are women, and we are damn, I think we are bloody good.
Kajol, you have ruled Bollywood. We all know that. But still, you feel there is a gender bias industry. There are many women-oriented films are being made now.
I do believe that. I've had this question, I think, quite a few times. Yes, there is, but I think it has more to do with society than a particular field. I think it has more to do with society. It has more to do with what kind of films you as an audience watch as well. If you as an audience choose to make Wonder Woman the most highest grossing film in the world, you will make her pay parity. There will be no pay parity. You understand what I'm saying? So I think that's very important, that you have to understand that it has to be a societal change. You can't blame a particular field on it and say that this is ye film industry ki problem hai, ya ye iski problem hai, ya ye iski problem hai, ye kisi aur ki problem nahi hai, ye hamari problem hai. Aur hum sabko jo hai, milke awaaz bhi uthani padegi, lekin mujhe lagta hai sabse zyada humko khud mein aur hamare jitne bhi log hain, hamare bacche hain, jaise Neena ji ne kaha hai, unko bhi badlaav dikhana hai. जैसे मेरे बेटे ने मुझे पूछा तो मामा यू आर नॉट एट होम टुडे सो आई सेड नो बेबी आई एम गोइंग फॉर वर्क सो ही इज लाइक ही टर्न्स अराउंड एंड ही इज लाइक यू नो बट आई वांट यू टू स्टे एट होम इट्स माय सैटरडे आई सेड या बेबी बट यू नो आई हैव टू गो फॉर वर्क एंड वर्क इज वर्क वर्क काम भगवान होता है और आपको भी स्कूल जाना है मुझे भी काम पे जाना है इट्स द सेम थिंग अगर मैं ये अपने बेटे को सिखा सकती हूँ तो मेरा बेटा बड़ा होके जब उसकी गर्लफ्रेंड आएगी या उसकी बीवी आएगी तो उसको भी समझ में आएगा कि दिस इज अ नॉर्मल पैटर्न सो आई एम चेंजिंग द फ्यूचर टुडे बाय चेंजिंग माय सन्स थिंकिंग सो आई थिंक दैट लाइक आई सेड ये सबकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है हम सबको सीखना है अगर हमको आत्मसम्मान चाहिए तो हमको आत्मसम्मान सीखना भी पड़ेगा और हमको आत्मसम्मान सिखाना भी पड़ेगा
नीना जी, इस बारे में आप क्या कहती है? आप भी काफ़ी सीनियर है, मराठी खासकर इंडस्ट्री में राज किया है, मराठी प्लेज एज वेल एज हिंदी प्लेज एंड फिल्म्स आल्सो, तो इस बारे में आपका क्या कहना है, क्या सोच है?
जैसा कि मैंने कहा कि मैंने जब शुरुआत की थी तो सीरियसली वी डिडंट हैव एनी इश्यूज लाइक दिस, इतना बड़ा मीडिया भी नहीं था और कोई इसके बारे में बात नहीं करते. आई मीन रैंडमली इफ आई वांट टू गिव एन एग्जांपल इन मराठी थिएटर, मुक्ता वुड नो, इन शिवाजी मंदिर वी टू हैव अ प्लेस, वी लिटरली हैड वन कर्टन टू चेंज, आई वाज नॉट इवन कॉन्शियस ऑफ चेंजिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ मेन एंड दे डिडंट इवन लुक एट अस दैट वे. सो आई थिंक देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ म्यूचुअल रिस्पेक्ट, यू नो, बिटवीन मेन एंड वुमेन देन, एंड व्हिच आई थिंक टुडे हैज बीन टार्निश्ड अ बिट. Today's men, women, for some reason, I don't know. I grew up in a society where this was not there at all. My parents were doctors. My mother was a doctor who used to work in one of these slum areas. She used to go there 11 o'clock in the night. But those thoughts didn't come, but the thoughts that come today, it must be obviously happening, but the kind of discrimination you see today, like my children are working today in the media again, and they have encountered things, not my son as much as my daughter. The exploitation is there even today in corporates, in private. So as Kajol said, it's not only at this industry. It's not like that at all. But yes, as I grow older today, I do feel, yes, there is a gender bias. Mostly, maybe men are getting better roles than I do. Maybe it's that, you know, it could be a very selfish thing to say. But then I look out for roles elsewhere. And there are lots of mediums to look out to. I think, again, it comes down to you have to be yourself and you have to be proud of who you are and not compare yourself to a man all the time and say he's, and respect the men for what they are. I mean, you know, there are certain qualities in a man which will not be there in a woman and vice versa. So we have to have mutual respect also for each other. And I think I've carried on my life like that and I hope to carry on till the day I die.
So I guess, thank you so much for asking such wonderful and interesting questions. Now, before we wrap up, we are going to take a selfie with all you Devis, with our Devis as well. So I'd recommend all of you all to stand up and turn this way so that we can take a selfie. You are the one who is going to take the selfie. And I'd request the...
बहुत ही, हाँ जी, बहुत ही अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था. जब मुझे स्क्रिप्ट पहले आई निरंजन और रायन के थ्रू, जो इलेक्ट्रिक एप्पल्स के प्रोड्यूसर्स हैं और मेरे बहुत अच्छे दोस्त भी हैं, उन्होंने कहा कि एक बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग, हार्ड हिटिंग और इम्पैक्टफुल स्क्रिप्ट है. मैंने कहा ठीक है. जब मैंने स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ा तो मुझे इतना, आई वॉज सो मूव्ड एंड सो टच्ड एज अ वुमन, एज अ ह्यूमन बींग, एंड आई फील वेरी ऑनर्ड एंड हैप्पी दैट आई एम अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस. आई थिंक, हाँ जी, अवेयरनेस एक स्टेप बाय स्टेप चीज़ होती है. शायद एक ही पल में एक बड़ा चेंज नहीं आ सकता, लेकिन छोटे छोटे कदमों से एक बड़ा डिफरेंस आ सकता है. एंड आई थिंक दिस इज वन सच स्टेप. हाँ जी, तो अभी तमिल में मैं एक फिल्म कर रही हूँ, लाभम, और तेलुगु में एक फिल्म क्रैक, एंड हाँ, अभी के लिए वो है और माई म्यूजिक इन द यूके. हाँ जी, इंडिया में हम कोलैबोरेशंस करने वाले. आई डोंट नो, इट डिपेंड्स. थैंक यू.
You're getting hidden otherwise.
Like this?